बोमन ईरानी जी की मुन्ना भाई एमबीबीएस के स्टोरी के बाद मैडम ने मेरे को जीडीपी पे बोलने के लिए खड़ा कर दिया है. सो रिस्पेक्टेड रुजुता जी, शिवानी जी एंड इन ऑल दिस वुमन पावर दे हैव मेड मी सिट इन बिटवीन. वन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग जर्नलिज्म, वन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग पॉलिटिक्स एंड इन बिटवीन बोथ ऑफ देम पुअर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट इज सिटिंग. सो with that we'll start to this discussion. Happy afternoon friends. Today's topic, major portion of today's topic was about happiness. Madam was talking about har shakhs pareshan kyun hai aur wo happiness kahan pe kho gaya hai. So I thought like wishing you in some happy manner. Why to wish only good afternoon and why not to wish happy afternoon? Now this is how we wish each other in our organization. Hamara jo office hai Guru and Jana, उसमें हम लोग इसी तरीके से विच करते हैं ईच अदर, हैप्पी मॉर्निंग, हैप्पी आफ्टरनून एंड हैप्पी इवनिंग. यू नो व्हाट, फॉर यू टू विश हैप्पी मॉर्निंग यू हैव टू फील हैप्पी फ्रॉम इनसाइड. यू कैन नॉट विश हैप्पी मॉर्निंग टू एनीवन विद द सैड फेस. यू नो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू फील हैप्पी फ्रॉम विद इन. एंड ऑफकोर्स आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट वन ऑफ द सैड गाइज इन आवर ग्रुप जो ना जन्म से एकदम उदास चेहरा लेके आता रहता है. You know, वो एक they have done PhD in their sadness. जब भी anything exciting happens around, उसके मुंह में कभी भी वो देवदास का चेहरा है, right? And now please don't look towards your neighbor. Happiness has to be the life, but with that, what is the connection of GDP? We'll discuss in next 20 minutes. Friends, when we are discussing about this GDP, I don't want to discuss it in a very technical, complex finance terms and all that, because I know a lot of you are not from finance background, so we'll try to keep it as simple as possible. You know, I don't want it to sound it like the definition of machine in the movie Three Idiots. How many of you remember that scene? Amir Khan and the profession? Oh, almost everyone. No, this is the beauty of youngsters. You know, I mean, ये चीज के लिए ना कोई revision नहीं लगता है, कोई homework नहीं लगता है, कोई discussion नहीं लगता है. We just like that remember all these things. I'll just out of this topic for interest, you know, I'll just ask few questions to you. Let me know how many of you remember know that. How many of you know the name of son of Kareena and Saif Ali Khan? See, where does Virat Kohli's and Anushka Sharma's marriage happen? Who is the latest couple that has got married in a Bollywood now? What is the economy of India? ये तो कोई मूवी में आया ही नहीं. वी नेवर डिस्कस दिस इन मूवी, बट दैट इज व्हाट आई लाइक अबाउट ऑल ऑफ अस. यू नो आई मीन दैट एनर्जी हैज टू बी देयर, दैट मस्ती हैज टू बी देयर. सो आई ट्राई टू पुट दिस जीडीपी इन एज सिंपल एज पॉसिबल. आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस वर्ड एटलीस्ट, दैट इज जीडीपी. दिस इज जीडीपी इज ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट, राइट? व्हाट इज जीडीपी मिल्क? GDP, I'll put it in a very simple term, is monetary value of all the goods and services produced in an area in a given time. Simple as that. Monetary value of goods and services produced in an area in a given time. So in an area is what? So for example, India's GDP we calculate Maharashtra's GDP, or for that matter we'll calculate Nagpur's GDP in an area and in a given time. So we calculate GDP for a quarter or for a year. So it's as simple as monetary value of goods and services produced in an area in a given time. You know, I'll tell you a few interesting facts about Indian GDP and Indian economy. Today we are already sixth largest economy, right? Where the other developed countries are struggling to achieve growth rate of 3 to 4% of GDP, we are easily reaching up to 7% of GDP. You know, in first quarter of this financial year 1920, we got 8.2% as our GDP rate. 8.2%, and friends, that's a remarkable rate. Developed countries are not able to achieve 3 to 4% of rate. You know, all the big businessmen across globe, they are interested in coming to India and investing in India because they believe in a growth story of India. You talk about Microsoft, you talk about Google, you talk about Facebook, all of them are interested. Just to give an example, Boeing, aeroplane manufacturing company, they have manufacturing facility only in California and Europe. In the whole world, they have manufacturing facility in only these two places. Now, apart from these two places, these people are coming in India, making investment in India, and starting their manufacturing in India. You know, whole world is looking towards India for next 15, 20, 25 years. They're believing in growth story of India. You know, this week Standard Chartered International released a very beautiful report, very exciting and interesting report. You know what they said? Till now, we even knowing that India is sixth largest economy, and they were saying that India is going to become fourth largest or so. Very soon it will become fourth largest. But Standard Chartered International is of opinion that by 2030, 2030, India will become second largest economy. India is going to become second largest economy after China. And the best part, even exciting part, is that India will cross even US economy. India will cross even, can you believe, friends, US, who on the basis their economy leads whole world, dictate terms to the whole world, and will be crossing them. But 2013, it's just 12 years from now, 10 years from now. That's the beautiful side of Indian economy. And I'll tell you other part, why these big business houses believes in India's growth story. I'll give you next another part of it. And that's even exciting for you students also. Friends, in a world, there are three type of countries. Developed countries, underdeveloped countries, and developing countries. Right? Developed countries, can anyone give me example of developed country? US, Europe, Australia, UK, these are the developed countries. Developing country? India. We are a developing country. And underdeveloped countries are those. Pakistan is most underdeveloped country, we all will agree, in different terms, you know. Where the even basic minimum facilities are not available, those are the countries which are underdeveloped countries. Now, what economic history says is, in any kind of country, whenever any transition happens from lower type of country to higher, underdeveloped to developing or developing to developed country, whenever this kind of transition happens, huge economic development is in store in that country. And friends, India has already moved towards, the transition in India is already started happening from developing to developed country. India has already started moving from developing to developed country. And this transition doesn't take in 1 or 2 days. It doesn't happen in 1 or 2 days. It takes anywhere between 15 to 30 years. But whenever this transition happens from developing to developed countries, there are lot and lot of economic development, infrastructure development, research and development, lot of new avenues, lot of new opportunities comes up. You know, I normally tell all the students wherever I go, you people are luckiest generations, because in next 10 to 15 years, the kind of opportunities you will have about your career, the kind of business opportunities you will have, those were not available anywhere since last 70 years of independence. You will have those opportunities, subject to you make yourself ready enough to grab those opportunities. Subject to you make yourself able enough to grab those opportunities. Coming back to our topic of today, friends, GDP versus GDH, gross domestic happiness, right? What is more important? Friends, there is no doubt in probably any one of us mind that happiness is certainly required at the end of everything. All human efforts, jo bhi hum log karte hai, jo bhi mehnat karte hai, jo bhi activities karte hai, uska end happiness or peace mein hi hona chahiye. Any wealth creation that we are doing should end in happiness and peace. You know, even the happy people only can create a great organization, create great results. There's no doubt about it. You know, jo aadmi sirf paise ke piche bhag raha hai, khushi nahi dekh raha hai, peace nahi dekh raha hai, ek Hindi shayar ne bahut acche tarike se uske bare mein kaha hai, insaan bhi kya cheez hai, daulat kamane ke liye apni sehat kho deta hai, aur wahi sehat wapas paane ke liye daulat kho deta hai. Jeeta aise hai jaise kabhi marna hi nahi hai, aur marta bhi aise hai jaise kabhi jiya hi nahi hai. Right? Now this is what happens if you don't look towards the happiness and peace in your life. It is certainly required. But here I want to make a different point. Here I want to give a different perspective to you. Right? Can happiness be achieved without having money in your pocket, friends? Can happiness be achieved without having money in your pocket? अगर कोई आदमी को दो दिन भूखा है, उसके पास जेब में पैसा नहीं है, तीन दिन से कोई रोटी नहीं खाई है, can he think about happiness? If someone in the family, close relative of yours, is not feeling well, there is a medical emergency, but you cannot take it to a good doctor because you don't have money in your pocket. Can you think about happiness? It's difficult. It's challenging to us, you know. And friends, in India, we are going through a different condition, right? And here I'm talking about the ordinary people. Ordinary people, जिसके लिए ना रोटी कपड़ा मकान आज भी उतना important है, ये necessities खत्म होने के बाद ही ना वो खुद के happiness के बारे में सोचता है. I'm not talking about the sadhus or monks, you know, जो सब मोह माया से मुक्त हो गए हैं. Correct? कुंभ मेला चल रहा है अभी. Correct? I'm not talking about those people. I mean, ये साधु लोगों के लिए क्या है? उनके लिए रोटी का कोई जरूरत नहीं, तो वो फल खा के जिंदा रह सकते हैं. कपड़ा दे hardly wear, you know? मकान for them, whole Himalaya is their मकान. पूरा हिमालय उनका मकान है. सो फॉर आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट देम, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑर्डिनरी पीपल जिनके लिए रोटी कपड़ा मकान जरूरी है. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इन आवर कंट्री वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ स्ट्रेंज इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशन वेयर वन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू बिकम अ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी. देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड पर कैपिटा इनकम. पर कैपिटा इनकम मीन्स इंडिविजुअल सिटीजन्स एवरेज इनकम इन ईयर, पर कैपिटा इनकम. एंड यू नो वॉट, इन आवर इंडिया, अपने देश में हम लोग पर कैपिटा इनकम के तौर पे 1,00,000 रुपया साल का ये फिगर तक समहाउ अभी पहुंचे हैं. सो पर कैपिटा इनकम इन आवर कंट्री इज 1,00,000 रुपीज पर एनम, राइट? दैट कम्स टू 8,000 odd rupees पर मंथ, राइट? एंड दैट आई एम टॉकिंग एवरेज पर कैपिटा इनकम. सो आज भी बहुत सारा हिस्सा अपने पॉपुलेशन का ऐसा है जो 30,000 to 40,000 rupees पर एनम इसमें इतना पैसा कमाता है. So what does it mean? Even more, less than 100 rupees a day. And in that 100 rupees, he has to manage his roti, he has to manage his kapda, makan, and then he can think about the happiness. You know, that is the strange situation we are going through as of now. Now, taking it through from global perspective, global picture kya hai? You know, nowadays, countries have started measuring their progress in the terms of happiness index. Apart from GDP, what is the happiness index? Forbes magazine every year publishes list of happiest countries in the world. Which are the happiest countries? So happiest countries as of Forbes magazine latest report is, say for example, Finland, Iceland, Denmark, Norway, Australia, New Zealand. These are the one of the happiest countries in the world. They say people living in these countries are very happy. You know, and how this happiness index is being measured? On the basis of their earnings, on the basis of their living standards, employment, medical facilities, on the basis of a higher average life expectancy rate, right? These are the few criteria on the basis of which happiness index is being measured. Friends, we talked about per capita income of India, that is 1,00,000 rupees per annum. Do you know the per capita income of these happy countries? The per capita income of this happy countries ranges between $45,000 to $75,000 per annum. Now to put it into Indian rupee terms, friends, the per capita income of this citizens of these countries is around 50,00,000 rupees per annum. 50,00,000 rupees per annum. Why will they not be happy? I mean, there is no reason otherwise they should not be happy. Of course, there are a few other aspects also which are contributing to their happiness index, but almost 50,00,000 rupees per annum. And why our per capita income is so low, even being the one of the greatest economies, is the population that we have, right? Friends, these countries have a very extremely low population. All these developed countries which I talked about, they have a population anywhere ranging between 45 to 50 lakh. See, 50 lakh ka population hai. Australia is 2 times bigger than India. And you know what is its population? 2.5 crore. 2.5 crore. And what's the population of India? Almost 130 crores. Right? That is the situation that we are facing our economy today. Going through a strange economic position. Now, how does it reflect in Indian economy? Global picture to chalo dhyan mein aa gaya, right? Even if the economy size is less than India, kyunki population bahut kam hai, their per capita income is more. What it happens in Indian terms? India mein apni economy bahut achhi chal rahi hai, bahut aage se chal rahi hai, right? GDP bahut achha badhne wala hai. Would it bring happiness? Would that GDP bring happiness? I doubt. In Indian structure, especially in our country, the situation is little difficult, situation little different. And the main hurdle in this doubt, or main the hurdle in this process, is our unequal distribution of wealth. Right? Hindi mein hum jise arthik vishamta kehte hain. And in typical layman words, garib aur amir ke beech ki duri. Right? Friends, do you know India is one of the worst countries as far as that unequal distribution of wealth is concerned. They say it's second from the bottom. Worst unequal distribution of wealth. 1% Indians possess 53% wealth of India. Can you imagine? 1% Indians possesses 53% wealth of India. You know, the only wealth of Ambani, Mukesh Ambani himself, is more than GDP of 19 countries. 19 countries GDP is less than his wealth. And that's how our wealth has got distributed, right? Unfortunately, this was the seen few days back, few years back, that rich is becoming richer and poor are becoming poorer. But the best part and the exciting, interesting part is situation is slowly changing. Government and people collectively putting all the efforts in reducing this gap between poor and rich people, you know. Government putting a lot of efforts toward this. They are trying a lot of different way to make a good upbringing of this poor people, right? Few schemes like electricity to all the people, medical facilities, banking, bringing them into the banking mainstream. You must have heard about Janadhana Yojana, right? It really impacted a lot for these people. Creating rural infrastructure to a great level so that the producers they produced in their villages, it can come to the market, it can come to cities and it can sell, you know. Making easy loans available at cheaper rate. These are the different measures government is taking to reduce this gap between rich and poor. You know, I read something very beautiful in a magazine, friends. It's a responsibility of every good human being to earn a lot of money. It's responsibility of every good human being to create a lot of wealth. Why? Because good human being will spend their money on good causes. And the whole money will get circulated in the hands of good people. You must have heard of charity that Tata's and Azim Premji does. Friends, Tata Group, 75% of their earning, approximately 75% of their earning, they spend in a philanthropic activities. Azim Premji, close to 25 to 30,000 crore rupees every year, you know, spend on charities. And why these big names? I just read in a newspaper in Pune, there is a businessman in Pune and his daughter's wedding was there and it was typical big fat Indian wedding, you know, and a lot of money was supposed to be wasted in those processes. He took a decision, he convinced his family, he convinced boy's family that we'll not waste this money, with this money we construct houses and we'll distribute it free to the poor people. Right? So instead of wasting that money on a wedding of daughter, they constructed houses and distributed it to poor people. All of us heard about that businessman in Gujarat who distributed cars to his employees. Right? Wo photo wagar humne WhatsApp pe kahin pe dekha rahega. Good human beings has a responsibility to earn a lot of money. Right? And another advantage India has in reducing that gap between rich and poor is its human resource capital. Friends, in India, 65% of our population is less than 35 year old. 65%, and it is the best in whole world. By 2020, average age of Indian would be 29 years. Average age of Indian by 2020 would be 29 years. And if you compare the same with China, it is 38 years. And Japan, the average age by next 2 years would be 48 years. So you can imagine the kind of opportunities India is going to have in coming future. Right? I would strongly say that it's a responsibility of every person sitting in this auditorium. In coming years, it's responsibility of all of you to earn huge money, create a lot of wealth, grow exponentially well, and in the process, help many enough people to grow along with you. It's not about how much wealth you have created at the end of it. It's about how many lives you have created in the process. Right? So it's responsibility of all of us to create lot of wealth, to earn a lot of money, right? At the end, I would say one sentence and with that I'll conclude it. As long as we work a lot collectively with government and with volunteers about reducing that unequal wealth distribution in the country, ye arthik vishamta kam karne ki aur jitna jyada hum log kaam karenge, utna hi jyada per capita income bhi badega, apna GDP pe badega, and in the whole process, apna happiness index bhi badega. Thank you, friends. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.